Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video. Today we will talk about something a little bit interesting. Well, I hope it is interesting. We're gonna talk about the Dodoco Tales. If I can just it's with Klee right now. Okay, Dodoco Tales. You should have your refinement 5 if you've just done the challenges a bunch of times, and it's pretty easy to get. But the question is it worth upgrading? Is it worth leveling up? Well, first things first, this book has a 1.5 experience bonus right now. So what I recommend doing is at least get it to 80, if not 90, because during this, like this time right now, it's the only time that you can get like 1.5 XP. That saves you around 200,000 mora if you just do it here, if you just do it in during this event. Because afterwards, you're not able to save on 200,000 mora. That's the only reason I would say you would level this up now versus later. Obviously, this book is pretty good for Klee. The 32% increase in charge attack damage is pretty nice, as well as the increase in attack. This book is for Klee, but is it the best in slot? I don't think so. I think the Lost Prayer is better, but it's definitely a contender. It is there. It is up there. The base attack of it is pretty low, but the attack percentage is roughly, it's pretty high. I'd say like 50%, 55% is the max you could get. It's pretty good. This book has a lot of benefits through its stats alone. Just the base attack is the only thing that's putting it down. However, if we compare it to other books, it is better. So what I'm going to be showing you guys is just a damage output, how much it can damage with some weird artifacts that I have and this weird set I have. Obviously, I'm going to show you guys the stats. These aren't the full stats. I'm going to show you guys in the... this is her stats right now. They are not the best, especially the crit rate and crit damage, because my artifacts are not upgraded at all. And they're not good either. The only two things I have upgraded is her feather as well as her goblet. Both very copium. I mean, the feather's pretty okay. Anyways, we move on. Her talents, 654. Not the best. Not looking good. Alright, we go. So now I hit it once and then boom. Now I should have both percentages in, but I'm wasting time right here. But now you guys can see my attack started at like 1550 or something like that, and now it's 1659, which is just a difference for sure. All right, now that's over. We can do this. Boom. 9165 right there. Boom. We're gonna wait for that to appear. Okay, hold on a minute. There it is. Now please, Jumpty Dumpty. 12,600, 10,000 right there. 10,000, it's pretty consistent. 13,000, that's a lot of damage with 2,389 damage. Wow, that was very consistent. She clapped right there. Wow, that was pretty good. I also want to try out Xing Qiu's Vaporize with Klee. Wow. I didn't do anything there, but there we go. We do that, and then Klee does this. A little vaporize going on. It's not bad. 6,000 for a vaporize, really not bad. All right, do this. We get rid of it real quick. All right, cool. We can defend ourselves here. Xing Qiu ult, boom ult. Now do that. Do that. Do that. Boom. 13k right there. Pretty good. It's pretty good. Not gonna cap. Especially because my Klee is not very bright. Let's just say that. She doesn't have artifacts that fit her at all. She doesn't have the, you know, the witch set or crimson witch set. So vaporize does not do more damage. And yeah, her talents aren't the greatest. But she does have pretty good attack because of the Dodoco Tales. I would say it's a pretty good outcome. We've got 13,000 damage out of
a charged attack.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, consider liking as well as subscribing to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Hopefully you guys got something out of this video. Anyways guys, that's gonna be it. See you guys in the next video. Goodbye.